Ensuas Mundo, representing the West Central Senatorial District. I'm going to talk as a senator and also as a mother, because I believe that there are too many problems going on in all households in Nigeria today. We have youths that have been law-abiding. We have youths that have always been having patience and cooperating with their parents. But right now, everything has gone in disarray in different homes. And it is not due to their fault, but due to the system. We must be aware of the fact that these youths, the aged people, they've actually voted us in, and we are here to represent them. We must be their voices. We must be able to explain, to tell the whole world and to tell the government what our people are going through. Our role as their representative is to be their voice and let the government know their concerns. Mr. President, during my contributions on the 2016 budget, I alluded to the fact that the public is not interested in rhetoric or theoretical prophecies about inflation, recession, exchange rate, or other terms they may understand. What our people want to know is, how are we going to solve their problems? We cannot just come here and start blowing grammars. We need to let people know, we need to let the executive arms know that there are three arms of government. There is no one arm. We must work together. Work together, speak in one voice, so that we'll be able to tell people. Nigeria is a country where corruption is endemic. This is a society where we don't believe each other at all. It is not the fault of the people writing things on the internet or everywhere, because they don't believe us. They don't believe that whatever we say is the gospel truth. We told people we need to explain to ensure that the judicial use of special intervention funds, which are in place to boost growing industries. However, there are widespread complaints that some of these funds were either not utilized or distributed as they were meant to be. For example, the Aviation Intervention Fund, which was to assist the airlines, was swallowed by the banks and used to offset existing debt brought by defeating the object or the objectives. It is the government's job to protect the future, because the public will not do it themselves. The public needs to be sensitized that Nigeria is going through a tough time, and there will be more trying times ahead. However, in order for them not to be a revolt, they must trust the government that they have their best interests in mind. We must do something that people must trust us. This can only be achieved if they hear positive things coming from all angles of the government. Excuse me. Particularly those at ends of affairs. We have made a push to patronize made in Nigeria products. But we need information on the progress of this. What is the state of our exports? And what progress has been made in the agriculture and raw materials industry? What is the investment in the future in terms of education? There is also nothing wrong in acknowledging the monumental task at hand and the endemic rot in the system. Our president integrated us of these challenges already. I mean, I will give an example. In 1984, during the reign of Margaret Thatcher in the United Kingdom, when the United Kingdom actually went into recess, what Margaret Thatcher did at that time was she managed to privatize some of the companies. She prioritized the British Telecom, the British Railway, the British Gas, British Airways, London Electricity, and the likes to private equity, with the knowledge that they would be run as viable businesses for profit. Government's role was simply to regulate the sectors in order to ensure that the public gets the best positive services, even if that is at a premium. But the problem we're having in this country is because people don't believe us, because people don't trust the government, people don't trust the system. It's a country where corruption is endemic. So if you now say you're going to prioritize everything, what they'll be saying is, oh, there are a set of people that want to buy all this by themselves. They will buy it for themselves, and they're not going to give the government the money. They will spend the money judiciously. Mr. President, the question we must ask ourselves is whether right now, today, the Nigerian government is capable of running these industries. If the answer is no, and we want the public to have access to better services, then they must be prioritized. We must be mindful of the fact that of certain industries does not mean that the government necessarily sells all shareholders. There are a number of ways to structure such arrangements. For instance, we can opt to prioritize. We cannot opt to prioritize at all with the hope that the government will somehow fix the industries. Then we don't need to prioritize. Secondly, we can completely offset government controlling shares and open the industries to market forces. And our role will then be regulators just like UK. Thirdly, we can engage private enterprises to manage the industries for us. But we will then be responsible for financing the cost, and we must realize that it's going to be very expensive. Another interesting option is to implement proper public-private partnership with transfer of ownership after a certain number of years. The goal must be the best way of ensuring services to the people within the shortest possible time scale. Opening up these industries is not a bad thing. Mr. President, it is widely agreed that the first airport in Nigeria is MM2 in Lagos. This is a privately run airport on a government concession. It is also a common fact that toll roads, such as the one in Lekki Road, are the best maintained roads because of the conditions attached to the concessions. We can also use the telecommunication sector as a case study for the positive role private equity can play in the provision of services. The sector was opened up before, and SIM cards cost 50,000 naira. We used to buy SIM cards 50,000 naira in Nigeria years back, but now they are free. Calls are also cheaper than they were before. This is due to competition. Telecoms is.
I think this is just, I have to say, Sarah, I'm going to give you a conclusion, sir.
GSM and landline companies could not compete and ended up folding while the other ones that remain are probably well. What is to say the same cannot happen in other sectors? However, I stress that there must be harmony. It is of paramount importance that the executive, the legislature, and the judiciary to an extent speak with one voice of hope and future prosperity for Nigeria. This is the only way that the public will have trust in the government. I therefore call for all arms of government to please work together. We all have to work together. The three arms have to work together. Only one arm cannot do it. And we believe that we are really a democratic government where it is government of the people, by the people. We need to listen to people to know what people actually want. We need to have people to contribute to what we are doing here. It is not that when they say, oh, I'm against selling of assets or I'm for it, that doesn't mean that whatever you say will be taken. But they have to wait to see which one will suit the country. People are really suffering. Youths are going around everywhere. They are not becoming honest people. and these are law abiding children, I will appeal that, as Dave said yesterday, to the Senate President and our principal officers, to please take all this communique straight to the President and hand it over to him by hand, so that he will know what people are saying. He will know what people are actually going through. We are here sitting down, we can afford our own 3 square meals, but there are some people that are waiting on this money that could not even take anything at all. I mean, I believe that we should think about others, think about grassroots. Let us see what can we do. In developed countries, there is welfare system where even if you don't have any job at all, the government will still take, I mean, will still look after you. I wish we'll be able to do this, and by the special grace of God, this is, and if we are not going to fail, and we are not going to fail people, and we hope that we have the best Nigeria to come. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.